We just got back from Orlando and we cannot wait. We're gonna try the brand new flavor, Keto Breck.
It's chocolate malt.
Right after this.
Hey, what's up, family? I'm Rachel.
And I'm Joe.
And we are Two Crazy Ketos.
If you're new to our channel, welcome. Here on Two Crazy Ketos, we do different things like recipe videos, we do product reviews, we talk about various keto topics, and then every Monday, we sit down on the couch for Keto on the Couch. We just kind of talk about what's going on in our lives for the week.
You can find us in different social media platforms like Facebook, Instagram, and Twitter.
And we have a website, which is twocrazyketos.com. That's where you're going to find all of our different recipes. Now, we do upload at least 5 new videos every single week, so make sure you subscribe to our channel.
And don't forget to hit the little bell icon, and that way, every single time we upload a new video, you'll be alerted to it.
Yeah. So, there is a brand new flavor Keto Brick coming out.
So, we just got home from Orlando. That's why I look like a total hot mess. I threw a hat on it, and I'm like, I can't wait. I don't want to wait until tomorrow morning. I want to taste it right now.
Yes. So if you don't know what Keto Brick is, this is a 1,000-calorie meal replacement bar. Now, you don't have to eat the entire bar in one sitting. A lot of people like ourselves melt them down. They cut it up into little pieces, eat like maybe half of it each day or a quarter of it each day or even just like, you know, an eighth of it each day.
I have tried, and y'all know how much I can eat in a sitting. I cannot eat a keto bar in a sitting. Yeah. I can't do it.
Now, here's the thing. In the past, Robert has always used pea protein in there. And by the way, Robert is Keto Savage, who is the creator of the Keto Brick.
Him and his wife, Crystal.
Yeah. And they've always used pea protein because they couldn't find a good quality source of whey protein. Well, guess what? This one is made with whey protein, and it's an exciting flavor. This is the chocolate malt flavor.
It makes me think of the old, like, diner days, right?
I'm so excited about this flavor. Are you ready to try it?
Yes.
Okay, so we've got 4 of them. Now, if you are interested in this flavor is coming out this Sunday.
Sunday.
Date right here across the bottom. And they will be released to the public at 12 noon Central Time.
Which used to be how all of the keto bricks were released, even when they would do it batch by batch.
Right. So I believe that date is June 7th. So this is a keto brick.
Looks like a brick.
Now here's the thing. We live in Florida. Sometimes they do come a little odd shaped during the summer where they can melt because they're going to melt down. That's why he's got this nice packaging. It kind of keeps it. But again, it's been very hot here lately, and it's pretty much not melted at all. So,
of course, what we usually do is melt it down into pucks.
Little pucks.
So you're not really worried about the shape.
You taking a first bite, or am I taking a first bite?
I'm taking the first bite this time. That is nice. Wow.
Mmm.
That's like a Whopper, right? A malt ball, chocolate malt ball.
Yeah.
It's like a Whopper.
Not overly sweet, but definitely that malted.
Mm-hmm.
And what I like.
It's got a crunch to it.
It's got a little bit of crunch to it. But what I like about it is we'll get into our 5 things review, but it's almost like if you're familiar with keto bricks at all, different ones have different textures. The last couple, the peanut butter, and they're very soft. The peanut butter and the toasted coconut one. The original mocha was a little bit more chalky. This is like a cross in between.
Well, and the original one had like the mocha one had coffee grinds in it. So you had something kind of chew on. And this has that, you know, almost like the center of a Whopper.
Yeah, it is. I love this. You want to do 5 things?
Yeah, 5 things.
5 things. So if you're new to our channel, we review all products based on 5 things. We're going to talk about the ingredients. Does the keto based on a nutrition label? How does it taste? How much does it cost? And finally, would we recommend it? We'll go through these real quick because we've done keto bricks before.
We have. We've actually done an entire week of nothing but a keto brick.
Yeah. Okay, so number one, the ingredients, because they are different than the other keto bricks.
Right.
So the ingredients in this are raw organic cacao butter.
Cacao.
Grass-fed whey protein, which is grass-fed whey protein and natural cocoa powder. Natural chocolate flavoring. Then we have Himalayan pink salt, stevia, guar gum, MCT powder, which is MCT oil and acacia fiber. raw organic cacao nibs.
Cacao.
Organic cacao powder, Himalayan pink salt.
So, great ingredients.
Super clean ingredients, which is one of the things that we love about it. And just notice there's no like sugar alcohols or anything in here like that.
It's not trying to be a keto bar. It's not trying to be
a candy bar.
Anything desserty.
This is a meal replacement bar.
It's all business.
But you don't have to eat the whole 1,000 calories in one meal. So number two.
What are the, does it keto based on the nutrition label?
Yep.
And the nutritional label says one brick is a serving size, which is kind of hilarious. Because seriously, try to get this all down in a sitting. I can't even do it. 1,000 calories. And that's why it's very calorie and fat dense. It's got 88 grams of fat. 88. Wow. It's got 32 grams of protein. There's 12 total carbs.
In the 1,000 calories.
12 total carbs. You've got eight dietary fiber. And then you've got the total sugars are 2, but...
4 net carbs for the whole bar.
For the whole brick. In all of 1,000 calories, 4 net carbs.
So it's about 80% fat. Now, if you want to compare that, you look at 12 total carbs for the whole bar. Compare that to the average, like, keto snack bar.
Sometimes it's 17, 18, 20.
Between 12 to 20 total carbs for a 200 to 250 calorie bar. So here you're looking at 12 total carbs for 1,000 calories.
Right.
So number three, how do they taste?
So it was interesting to get back a crunch because I have been used to the peanut butter one. Actually, the peanut butter one has been my absolute favorite. But I'm kind of liking this malt ball thing. Now, something about a malt ball, if you remember a Whopper, it kind of got stuck in your teeth a little bit. But not in a way that upset me. And that's how this is. There's like little pieces of it. That's the little middle of a malt ball.
Right.
And it gets a little stuck in your teeth. But it feels good. But the chocolate is on point.
I think it tastes amazing. Looking at all the different flavors. And we have tried every single flavor Keto Brick came out. In fact, we have pretty much all of them in our cupboard. Because I change what I want. Mm-hmm. My absolute favorite is peanut butter. My second favorite is probably the toasted coconut, which is kind of tied with the cookies and cream crunch one.
Right.
Okay, so what is your favorite is peanut butter?
Peanut butter has been my favorite. And then the next one I liked was the coconut that they had that had the shavings in it because the peanut butter was provided, you know, the soft texture when I didn't want to have anything crunchy. And then the coconut one was for when I wanted something crunchy. And this has definitely dethroned the coconut for me.
I was going to say, for me, this one is going to come in...
Number two.
I don't know. It might... It's going to depend on texture for me. Am I in the mood for a super soft, like, peanut butter thing?
Right.
Or this one? So this is going to be kind of up there with number one, number two, back and forth with that one.
I wonder if you could mix
some. I like the
some.
Flavor of this. Oh, yeah. That would be really good.
Mix them together and get, like, instead of 8 pucks from one, 16 pucks.
I think the taste is awesome. So, number four, how much do they cost? Now, you may get a little bit of a sticker shock on this, but I'm going to tell you it's completely worth it. So, if you buy one bar, which I would not recommend unless you have, or one brick, unless you have never tried it and you're really like, I don't know, because taste is subjective.
Yeah.
If you're looking for something sweet, this probably isn't it. If you want something that's got a little bit of sweetness, this is a good avenue to go down, especially if you don't want to trigger sweet tooths and stuff like that. But one bar is $12 because he's got to ship it. Everything gets shipped to priority mail.
Because this is all being made fresh and by them.
Right.
This isn't being shipped from some place you've never
heard
of.
There's no co-packer or anything like
that. No, it's all them.
So if you buy a week's supply, which is 7 bars, is $50. So what does that come out to be? About $7.50 a bar, something like that, right?
Now keep in mind, every single bar that we have, we melt it down into 8 pucks or fat bombs. If you are looking for the absolute best fat bomb,
there you go.
This is it. So now divide that $7 to $8 by 8. Now you're paying $1 a fat bomb.
Well, even if you look at the average like keto bar that you're gonna go out with those dessert bars, they're gonna be about $2.50 to $3.50 per bar. for 250 calories. So that means that four of them, you're averaging about $12. So here you're much cheaper. But if you buy a 2 week supply,
okay,
it's $90. So that works out to just over $6 a bar for 1,000 calories. Now keep in mind, this is a meal replacement. What meal can you go out to? Like, think about fast food. Think about on the go.
Mm-hmm.
Can you go to McDonald's and get 1,000 calories in clean food? Take it. You got to throw out the bun.
Yeah.
And that's half the calories when you buy a McDonald's hamburger.
Right.
So can you buy 1,000 calories in clean food at any fast food restaurant or an on the go for $6.50?
Well, and on top of that it's going to be perfect macros.
And clean.
That's the trouble, right? You never know. Like, how am I going to get my fat really up without getting my protein through the roof? Like, how am I going to have all of these things together with the perfect amount of carbs? He's done all of that thinking for you and has given you something easy and portable with a long shelf life.
Right. Because even if you think about a dozen eggs, if you get a dozen pasture-raised eggs, you're going to pay like, what, $6 to $7 a dozen?
Right.
And that's not even 800 calories. That's like, what is that? It's 70 calories per egg. So, and nowhere near the same profile that you have here. And by the way, technically more carbs, because a dozen eggs would be 12 carbs.
Yeah. So you really have to just kind of break it down and look at it that way. Otherwise, it's going to be really easy to be like, yeah, I don't think this would work.
Yeah.
It does, but you have to think of it in terms of serving size and what are you using for. This is one of those things that you can put it to work and it's going to accomplish what you need it to do.
Yeah. Number five, would we recommend it? We've always recommended Keto Brick. And again, taste is subjective.
It is.
Some people love Keto Brick. Some people don't like the taste of Keto Brick at all. I absolutely love it. We keep a bunch of them in the house. I think they're great for like a hurricane preparedness. They're great for on the go. There's something that doesn't trigger your sweet tooth.
We have used them and incorporated them in muffins that we've made.
Yeah, I'll leave a recipe for that right over your head.
So there's lots of stuff. They're very versatile. For us that are, you know, we're living in South Florida, this is a perfect pantry item for us. Hurricane season, we're in the midst of it right now. And you're looking, especially in this time, you know, how am I going to get my protein needs? What if the power goes out for 2 weeks? And we've been through a hurricane season where we've lost power for 2 weeks or more.
Yep.
And this is a great option because I don't even have to think about it. We're covered. We've got everything we need, you know, for weeks.
Yeah.
That's good.
Yeah. Well, that's going to be our video for today. If you had a keto brick before, let us know down in the comment flavor what your favorite flavor is. And again, the chocolate malt flavor is coming out. If you're seeing this, which is today is June 4th, 2020, if you're seeing it today, this flavor comes out on Sunday, June 7th at 12 o'clock Central Time.
Yeah. Now, I would like to know down in the comments, if someone has never tried Keto Brick before, what would be the flavor that you think would be a great onboarding Keto Brick? Because for me, I still think if you've never tasted before,
peanut butter
is the way to go. If you like a Whopper and you like the chocolate malt, you know, flavor, you're going to love this. This tastes really, really good. But I'm interested to see, what do you think would be the first one you would recommend flavor-wise?
Sounds good. Please do the favor, hit that like button down below.
And don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the little bell icon. And that way, every single time there is a new flavor of Keto Brick, you'll be alerted to it.
Until next time.
Bye.